number menu. Time for a nice lunch. It looks like Pato is ready to order. One orange. Very good.
One orange!
Oh dear. Well, how about one slice of watermelon instead? One slice of watermelon. Ah, poor Pato. Can you tell Pato how many hearts there are?
One heart.
That's it, one.
2 plus 2 is 4 and 4 plus 2 is 6. 6 plus 2 is 8 and 8 plus 8 16. 24 plus 8 is always 32. Now you know that Pocoyo can count like you.
Dig me. Good morning, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Going for a walk, I see. Chicken eggs. How curious. I wonder where their mother's gone.
What?
How wonderful! But still no mother.
Woo.
You'd better take care of these chicks until she returns. Do you think you can do it?
Yes, Pocoyó takes care.
You'd better follow them, Pocoyo. Maybe it's time to teach them to roost. Very good. Looks like you could use some help, Pocoyo. Maybe Pato?
No, Pato. Ellie helps Pocoyo.
Ellie? I bet she'd make a wonderful mother. Ellie, will you help Pocoyo mind these chicks? This is curious. Looks like someone's got those chicks in line. But who?
It's Pato!
What a surprise! You make a better mother hen than we thought. Amazing! You've done it! What's next, Pato? Flying! But chickens don't fly. Unbelievable! Well, you're just full of surprises, Pato. What could possibly be next? Oh no, Pato. What happened to your flock of chicks? Oh, their mothers found them at last. Well, of course, the chicks belong with their mother. Oh dear. Perhaps some rest will do you good. There we are, Pato. Get a good night's rest. Well, it looks like you've made new friends for good. Lovely. Good night, Pato. And good night to all.
Jumping on the bed. One bed. Pocoyo?
Hello.
Now let me guess. You're going to play catch.
Paso play.
No. Oh, come on, Pato. It's fun. Looks like Pato really doesn't want to play catch. Well, what do you want to do, Pato? I see the seesaw. Well, maybe you could play ball with Pocoyo and go on the seesaw afterwards. Oh, you'll only play on the seesaw? Oh, hi, Ellie.
Play?
Looks like Pocoyo's found someone to play with after all. Now, don't look so gloomy, Pato. You can go and play with them, you know. No. You're just going to sit and sulk, are you? That doesn't look like much fun by yourself. Can you tell Pato how many people it takes to play on the seesaw?
Two.
You need two people.
Yeah, that's right. The thing about seesaws is that you really need a friend to get any fun out of them. What's that, Pato? You say you've got a friend? The perfect friend? Who? But that's just a machine. I see that button turns it on. Goodness! Pato! That machine made another you! It looks as if you really have found the perfect friend, Pato. Someone just like you! Oh dear, you two want to play with the same thing. Another Pato? What will you two play? This seems more like it. You're right. These Patos didn't make such good friends after all. Maybe this one'll be perfect. Aha! Watering flowers, a favourite pursuit. That Pato likes watering as much as you do. A joke! Ha-ha! Wonderful! Oh, I suppose that Pato has heard your joke before, Pato. It seems this Pato wants to watch your other favourite channel. Another Pato? Oh dear, the Pato copy has copied himself! Pato, is this machine really helping you get what you want? You say those other Patos are selfish. They only want to play their way. Oh dear. Oh, perhaps this machine wasn't the best idea after all. Pocoyo, Ellie, Pato has a slight problem here. Can any of you tell Pocoyo and Ellie where to look to see the problem?
Behind you!
They're behind you!
Pato's everywhere! Oh, they're out of control! Oh. you've got an idea. Oh, do hurry. Oh, please hurry. Quick, quick. The machine, of course. Oh, dear. Do you think Pocoyo should press the button to turn the machine off?
Yes, push the button.
Oh, well, that's a relief. Hooray for friends! Hooray for being different to each other! What's this? Oh dear! Bye-bye! See you soon!
I've got a little dolly and she's dressed in blue, with a little shirt and her little shoes. I took her for a walk and she got the flu. I put her to bed, I don't know what to do. The doctor came this morning and he gave a talk. Give her all her medicine but with a fork. 2 plus 2 is 4 and 4 plus 2 is 6. 6 plus 2 is 8 and 8 plus 8 is 16. 24 plus 8 is always 32. Now you know that Pocoyo can count like two. I've got a little dolly and she's dressed in blue, with a little shirt and her little shoes. I took her for a walk and she got the flu. I put her to bed, I don't know what to do. Medicine, but with a fork. 2 plus 2 is 4, and 4 plus 2 is 6. 6 plus 2 is 8, and 8 plus 8 is 16. 24 plus 8 is always 32. Now you know that Pocoyo can count like you. 2 plus 2 is 4, and 4 plus 2 is 6. 6 plus 2 is 8, and 8 plus 8 is 16. 24 plus 8 is always 32.
Disco Fleaver.
Hi, Pocoyo. Hi, Nina.
Hi, Lita.
Oh, gee, I'm sorry. Hi, Lula.
No, Pocoyo. Lula's not dancing. She's scratching. But why? Ah, Nina, you know what the problem is? Oh, you've got fleas. That's why you're scratching yourself. What can we do about it?
Oh.
Herself. The fleas massage Lula instead of making her itchy. Congratulations, guys! Everyone gets a massage! And the fleas can dance as much as they want!
There were 10 in the bed and the little one said, roll over, roll over. So they all rolled over and one fell out. There were 9 in the bed and the little one said, roll over, roll over. So they all rolled over and one fell out. There were 8 in the bed and the little one said, roll over, roll over. So they all rolled over and one fell out. There were 7 in the bed and the little one said, roll over, roll over. So they all rolled over and one fell out. There were 6 in the bed and the little one said, roll over, roll over. So they all rolled over and one fell out. There were 5 in the bed and the little one said, roll over, roll over. So they all rolled over and one fell out. There were four in the bed and the little one said, roll over, roll over. So they all rolled over and one fell out. There were three in the bed and the little one said, roll over, roll over. So they all rolled over and one fell out. There were two in the bed and the little one said, roll over, roll over. So they both rolled over and one fell out. There was one in the bed and the little one said, I'm to sleep.
Tourist trapped.
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Lovely day, isn't it? Pocoyo, the little alien wants to take your picture. Beautiful flowers, Pato. I think your garden has some admirers. Very lifelike. How's ballet practice going, Ellie? Yes, it's very important to stretch. It seems you have some new fans. We've seen a lot of little aliens today, haven't we? Uh-oh. They want to take a selfie with your sandwich. Look out, Nina! Yeah.
It's time for the green aliens to go home to their own planet. He says, thank you for everything. You all had a wonderful time? Well, that's great. Ellie says you are always welcome to visit again. But maybe not all at once next time. You want to give them a snack for the trip home. Very nice, Pocoyo. Bye-bye, everyone.
Five little aliens jumping on the bed. One fell off.
Pocoyo should open it and find out.
Yes! Open it!
A door to the sky? Now that's unusual.
Sky, look!
Oh my! I wonder what happened to the sky. Yeah, I think Pato wants to keep watching the fish. Can any of you tell Pocoyo where Pato went?
He went through the door!
Pato, there you are! Pocoyo is looking for you! Wait! Oh, Pocoyo, you just missed him! Pato! Pato, wait! Oh, dear. Pocoyo, I'm afraid you just missed him again! Oh, my. That is one strange door. Try again. Did you see him? Yes, he was just there. There he is again! Oh my! Another door! More doors? Oh dear! Pocoyo, you can't give up. That sounded familiar. Can any of you tell Pocoyo who made that sound?
Pato!
I believe you're right. It sounded like Pato. Perhaps you ought to get some help, Pocoyo. Hello, Ellie.
Pato, Pato!
Hooray! You found him! What's that, Ellie? You're working on something. What could Ellie be working on that's so important? That's what Ellie was busy with. She was preparing a party. What fun! Hooray for Pocoyo! Hooray for not giving up! Bye-bye! See you soon!
Number menu!
Bye.
one. It looks like Pato is ready to order. Two bananas. Very good.
Two bananas!
Oh, dear. Well, how about, two pineapples instead?
Two pineapples.
Poor Pato. Can you tell Pato how many hearts there are?
Two hearts.
That's right, two. Look, it's Pocoyo. Hello, Pocoyo.
Big, small.
What's that?
Pato! Look, big, small.
I think Pocoyo has something to show you. Wow! That's really big. Oh, now that's really small.
Small. Bye.
Surfing the net with Ellie.
Hi, Ellie.
Ellie. Search, Ellie.
Pocoyo wants you to search for a word on your computer.
Tall.
Ellie is searching for something tall. It's Pato. Look, he's tall. Wow, really tall.
More. Short.
Pocoyo would like you to search for something short. Pato is short now. Really short.
Thank you, Ellie.
Yes, thank you, Ellie. Well done. It's Ellie. She's having a picnic with her doll. How nice.
Ellie!
What's that? Oh dear. Can you tell me, is the doll big or small?
Small! The doll is small!
Now is the doll big or small?
Big! The doll is big!
Bye!
Shape shuffle. A circle.
Circle!
A square.
Square.
A star.
Star.
Circle, square, star. What's this, Pocoyo?
Hot air balloon.
I see. You've made a hot air balloon with circles, squares, and stars. Helicopter.
Helicopter.
Can you tell me the names of the shapes? What are these?
Circles. They're circles.
And these?
Squares.
And these?
Stars. They're stars.
Circle, square, star. Oh my, poor Lula. Now, Pocoyo, that really isn't very nice.
Big, small.
Yes, it's a wonderful remote, but you haven't been very nice to Lula, or Ellie, or Pato.
I fixed.
Much better. The bone. And the doll. And the blocks. Bravo, Pocoyo!
Yay!
Everything is right again. Hooray! Nice lunch. It looks like Pato is ready to order. Three sandwiches. Very good.
Three sandwiches.
Oh dear. Well, how about three apples instead? Three apples. Goodness. Poor Pato. Can you tell Pato how many hearts there are?
Three hearts.
That's right. Three.
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
So, what are you going to do today, Pocoyo?
Play!
Play! What a splendid idea! And who are you going to play with, Pocoyo?
Friends!
Friends! Of course, what a silly question. What's that? I hear it too, Pocoyo. I think it's coming from above you. Can any of you tell me who it is on that cloud?
Baby bird!
It's baby bird!
Yes, it's baby bird! He seems to be having loads of fun. What's that, baby bird? What are you saying? You would like Pocoyo to play up there with you? But Pocoyo can't fly.
Hmm.
I think Baby Bird wants you to try to fly, Pocoyo.
No!
It's nothing to be upset about, Pocoyo. It was a very good try.
Pato.
Yes, it sounds like Pato.
Play.
Look at that. Can any of you tell Pocoyo who's making that noise?
It's Lula!
Lula.
Yes, it's Lula.
Lula, Lula.
Now there's someone you can certainly play with. Oh dear, this is getting to be so difficult. Poor Pocoyo. He can't seem to play with his friends. Someone you can play with. It's Caterpillar. Oops. Oh, Pocoyo. Sometimes your friends can do things that you can't do. But the nice thing about real friends is that they'll always find a way for you to join in. This is strange. You seem to be floating, Pocoyo. How could that be? Oh, I see. Hooray for friends! Hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye. See you soon.
Number menu. Time for a nice meal. It looks like Pato is ready to order.
for aubergines. Very good.
Four aubergines.
Oh dear. Well, how about four eggs instead?
Four eggs.
Four eggs. Poor Pato. Can you tell Pato how many hearts there are?
Four! Four hearts!
That's it! Four!
Hello, Pocoyo!
Hi!
But what's that you're doing? Following somebody's trails? I wonder who left those footprints. They're rather small. I think I know. They are exactly the same size as Pocoyo's feet. Can anyone help Pocoyo guess who made those footprints?
Pocoyo!
It's Pocoyo's feet.
They're quite right. Pocoyo, you're following your own footprints. But what's that? Look, there are more footprints. And whoever left them isn't wearing shoes at all. In fact, I think they've got little paws instead of feet. Who left those prints? Do you know, Pocoyo? Well, did you leave those prints, Pocoyo? Can any of you help Pocoyo guess whose prints those are?
A dog!
It's Lula!
Why, you're right! It was Lula! You see, sometimes we leave tracks or prints behind us, like when we walk on sand at the beach. Now those are very mysterious. Who or what do you suppose left those?
Round.
Yes, they are round.
Big.
You're right. It's big too. Much bigger than your footprint, Pocoyo. Big, round feet. I wonder who on earth it could be. Pocoyo, do you know who could be leaving these tracks? Can any of you tell Pocoyo who has been making these big, round tracks?
Ellie!
You're right! It's Pocoyo's good friend, Ellie. Hello, Ellie! You certainly do have big feet, Ellie. Now here's someone who's leaving some very interesting footprints. Hello, Pato. Going for a swim? What sort of prints are these?
Big!
Yes, whoever left these prints has great big feet, even bigger than Ellie's. And whoever it is has webbed feet.
whoever left those footprints, it certainly wasn't a boy, a dog, or an elephant, was it, Pocoyo? So who could it be?
What's that?
Oh, no, Pocoyo. I don't think it could be a monster. Pocoyo? Pocoyo? If you just take a look... Pocoyo, I know it looks as though the monster is very close by, but really, there's no need to panic. Look, Pato, that's strange, isn't it? The prints are right behind you. Can you see who left those scary-looking footprints, Pocoyo? Can any of you tell Pocoyo whose feet match these footprints?
Pato!
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 It was Pato all along, in his flippers, going for a swim. Hooray for Pocoyo! You solved the mystery of the great big monster. Good work. Bye-bye. See you soon.
Number menu. Ah, time for a nice lunch. It looks like Pato is ready to order. 5 apples. Very good.
5 apples.
5 apples. Oh, dear. Well, how about 5 mushrooms instead? Pato. Can you tell Pato how many hearts there are?
5 hearts!
That's it! 5.
Hello, sleepy bird. Oh, sorry. You go back to sleep, sleepy bird. Ah, hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Ah, come to see your old friend Sleepy Bird, have you? I'm afraid she's asleep as usual. Oh, wait a minute. Is she waking up? Oh, no. I think it's something else. Oh, my word. Oh, that was so close. Pocoyo? It's not actually a... Thank you, Pato. Yes, I suppose it does look like a ball, but it's shaped a little differently. Oh, I know. Can you help Pocoyo? Can any of you tell him what that is?
Egg!
It's an egg!
better. Eggs can break, I'm afraid, Pocoyo, if you're not careful. And do you know what's inside that egg waiting to come out? Ah, Pato knows. There's a baby bird inside that egg, Pocoyo.
Baby?
That's right. I had no idea Sleepy Bird was sitting on an egg. That egg belongs up there in Sleepy Bird's nest with its mother. Oh dear, you'd best catch it, Pocoyo. Sleepy Bird will be very worried if she wakes up. Oh, there it goes! Catch it, Pocoyo! Pato, you catch it now! No, it's coming the other way! Quickly, quickly! Pato, it's behind you! Oh, my word! Oh, well done! Now, if we could just get Sleepy Bird's attention. Sleepy Bird! Sleepy Bird! Sleepy Bird! She certainly is a sound sleeper, isn't she? Nothing wakes that bird up. I suppose we'll have to find a way to get it up there ourselves, then. Yes, I'm afraid it is quite high up, Pocoyo. Perhaps we need someone taller to help us. But who? Can any of you tell Pocoyo someone who is tall enough to help us?
Ellie!
That's right! Well done. That's where an egg belongs, snug in its nest. Hooray for Pocoyo! Something's happening to the egg.
Egg. Egg.
Oh, don't worry, Pocoyo. Come closer now. You won't want to miss this. Yes. It's a little sleepy bird. Or a little not-so-sleepy bird. Well, in any case, it looks like we all have a new friend who we'll be seeing more of. If we can catch him, that is. Bye-bye. See you soon.
Number menu. Time for a nice lunch. It looks like Pato is ready to order. 6 oranges. Very good.
6 oranges!
Oh dear. Well, how about 6 lemons instead? Six lemons.
Ah, poor Pato. Can you tell Pato how many hearts there are?
Six.
That's it, six.
Pocoyo and Lula are going to the beach today. Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Lula, too.
Hi.
That's right. A day at the beach. They have a picnic lunch and a beach umbrella and... Pocoyo, where are you going? That's not the way to the beach. Ah, good idea, Pocoyo. A ball. A round, orange, little ball. What a good thing to take with us.
Round?
Yes, round, like a circle. Very good, Pocoyo. Well, I'm sure Lula will love to play fetch with it in the sand. Now, we'd better get... Pocoyo, the beach is, not that way either. Oh, dear. There you are. Now, where is that ball? Do you see it, Pocoyo? Which one is it? Can any of you tell Pocoyo which one is his ball?
The round one.
It's round.
Round.
That's right, Pocoyo. Your ball is round. Now we can go to the beach. Our friend Pato seems to be having fun. Very nice, Pato. But, oh, look out! Phew, that was close, wasn't it, Pato? Uh-oh, here comes Lula. Oh, poor Pato, and after he worked so hard. Pato, I think Pocoyo's ball is somewhere in here. Can you help?
Round.
Yes, Pato's right. Everything here seems to be round. But wasn't there something else about your ball, Pocoyo? Can any of you tell Pocoyo which one is his ball? Oh, Lula sees it too. Oh, no, not again. Sorry about that, Pato. Oh, juggling! How clever! Look out! Oh, dear. Hello, Ellie.
Ellie!
Oh, this looks a bit more difficult, doesn't it? Perhaps you should tell Ellie what your ball looks like.
Rounds. Orange.
No, that's not it. What else did we say about the ball? It's round, it's orange, and... Can any of you help Pocoyo work out which one it is?
It's little!
Little.
Good thinking. So, now that you've got your ball, do you think we can finally go to the beach? The beach! Oh, I see. Well, I suppose we got here after all. Hooray for Pocoyo! All in all, it's a lovely day for Pocoyo. And for me too, for that matter.
Bye-bye.
Bye. See you soon.
Number menu. Time for a nice lunch. It looks like Pato is ready to order. 7 mushrooms. Very good.
7 mushrooms!
Oh dear. Well, how about 7 strawberries instead? Seven strawberries. Ah, poor Pato. Can you tell Pato how many hearts there are?
7 hearts.
That's it, 7.
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hello.
What shall we play today, Pocoyo? Yes, I see it too, Pocoyo. Something shiny. I'm not sure Pocoyo knows what that is. Can any of you tell Pocoyo what this is?
It's a key!
Key!
Exactly, a key! And who knows what surprises it might unlock? How exciting! Yes, and you know, if I didn't know better, I'd say that was the kind of key they once used to open old pirates' treasure chests.
Treasure? Treasure! Treasure! Treasure, treasure, treasure. Treasure.
That's amazing. It looks like... It is a keyhole, Pocoyo.
Treasure?
Give it a try. Well, I don't know about... treasure, but I've never seen anything like that before.
Hello. Treasure. Treasure. Treasure.
Well, there's no treasure here. Sorry for waking you, sleepy bird.
Key. Treasure. Treasure! Key! Treasure! Treasure! Treasure!
Hey, hey! Another keyhole! Ooh, I didn't realize we had a basement.
Treasure! Treasure! Treasure!
Surprised to see us, Pato?
Treasure battle! Treasure, treasure!
Wow, a lift! How exciting! Go on, give it a try. Now they're on the bottom of the sea. Well, this looks like it's as far as you can go, doesn't it? I don't believe it! Look!
Treasure! Treasure!
You know, I think it just might be. Nothing would surprise me after what I've seen today. Go ahead, Pocoyo. Open it. I wonder what's inside. Sweets? Toys? What could the treasure be? What is it? What's there? Will all of you go and look and tell me what's in the treasure chest?
It's lots of keys!
Treasure!
This is the best treasure of all, isn't it? After the fun we've had today. Keep opening doors, asking questions, and exploring your world. That is the key to it all. Hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye. See you soon.
Number menu. Time for a nice lunch. It looks like Pato is ready to order. 8 carrots. Very good.
8 carrots!
Oh dear. Well, how about 8 cherries instead? Eight cherries. Ah, poor Pato. Can you tell Pato how many hearts there are?
8 hearts.
That's right, 8.